What's up, VFAM? Your boy Juan Valdez here. Today I wanted to make a quick video going over goals, specifically how to set goals and how to actually achieve them. The reason I wanted to do that is because a few weeks back, I actually posted on Instagram and Snapchat a post of me and my goals, and I got a lot of feedback from a lot of different people, so I figured why not take a second and kind of go over and talk about goals and my approach when it comes down to it. Now, I know you guys see I got a little bit of a different setup here. I actually moved my setup in my home office from my room into the living room. You can see right here, this is the new setup I got going on right here. It used to be just Samir working right over there, my business partner, but now my desk is over here, so this is where I'm working from now. You can see it right here. And we got Pluto right here, who's sleeping, but he's usually cranking and getting some work done. But I realized I found myself, you know, when I was working out of my room, often trying to take naps, right? I feel like I got more tired throughout the day since I was always working in my room and my bed was always right there. So I figured I'd switch things up a little bit. But to kind of get right into it, right, I wanted to obviously give a huge thanks and shout out to you guys for showing me tons of love and support. The VFAM just crossed 6,000 subscribers, so that's obviously huge. And of course, our goal is to get to 100,000. But now, to kind of just get right into it, when it comes down to goals is something that I find super important. It's something that has changed the way I look at things and, you know, has changed my life, honestly, because before I learned about goals and the importance of having goals set and actually setting goals, I would pretty much go all my day with no exact purpose, right? And that's how I found out that, you know, there was something that I wasn't doing. There was something missing, because if every day you're just going about your day and you don't really have a purpose and you don't really know like what you're working towards, then you could be wasting a lot of time, right? And your days could just be just going to complete waste. I found myself in that situation a little while ago. You know, luckily I found this one goal setting workshop by Jim Rohn. I would actually recommend for you guys to actually go through this workshop. It's about an hour long workshop, I believe, but this goal setting workshop was probably one of the best workshops I've ever been through when it comes to actually setting goals. And that's how I first got introduced to goals and the importance of it, and kind of how I started wrapping my head around goals. When it came down to it, there was this powerful quote that Jim Rohn said, and shout out to Jim Rohn. He was one of my first mentors and most influential mentors, I would say, for sure. He said he can probably, he got this from one of his mentors, and his mentor told him that he can probably guess the amount that he had in his bank account by his goals. And I personally thought, well, I couldn't agree a lot more. I'm pretty sure if somebody told me that, if he told me the same exact words, he could probably guess how much I had in my bank account at that time, because I had no goals, right? So obviously I didn't have much money. After I really got into that and got into personal development and started learning more about goals and the importance of goals, that's when like things really clicked. And I really started to understand the power behind it. And so for me personally, that workshop isn't something I do like every single day. It's something that I do, I would say, every few months, because of course a lot of things change in a short time frame. You know, I've already came and had a good amount of progress, thank God, in, you know, within a short year. So obviously once things change, usually goals change. And so for me, I do that workshop, I would say, every like 6 months or so, because it is an intense workshop, right? Basically you break down goals for not only months in advance and days, but then years as well, like 5, 10 and even 15 year goals. So that one's a lot more in depth. Now I like to have my goals set up between that workshop that I do specifically like once or twice a year, and then I also like to have goals that I write down every single day in and day out. That's something that I actually learned from one of my other mentors, Grant Cardone. Something that he's huge on is writing down his goals first thing in the morning and last thing right before he goes to bed. And that's something I do as well. And it's something that I try to do within my environment, right? So obviously you guys don't have a business partner, his name's Samir, and we have a team that we work with as well. And we try to have everybody else that's in the team also do the same, because I believe that if the people you are around also don't have any goals set, then they can also influence you in either in a positive or negative way. Now obviously not everybody's goals are going to be the same. I probably don't have all these kind of goals that I write down every single day, but I do try to diversify with the different types of goals that I set. So not only do I have like financial goals, but I have like lifestyle goals, I have family goals with things I want to do for my family, I have friendship goals, right? Things that I want to be able to do with friends. So there's a lot of different kinds of goals. Can't find the exact, there was a breakdown that I saw somewhere else of like specific kind of goals, but basically you wanted to for sure have like short-term goals and long-term goals and lifetime goals. A lot of different goals already set, but the goals that I write down day in and day out, that for me are super important are goals that working towards every single day. So obviously I'm working towards my biggest picture goals, but I have specific goals that I'm working to that may be like a few months down the road goals that I want to accomplish within the next few months. I have goals that I want to accomplish within the rest of the year, right? The goals that I write down every single day are shorter term goals. They're not long term goals. And for me, that's important because for me, I find that if I have shorter term goals that I'm writing down day in and day out, as well as like with one lifetime goal, it makes it a lot easier for me to know exactly what I'm working towards every single day. Because what happens is if you have just like huge goals that you're working towards, then it's kind of hard to see the things you're working towards because those goals, it's probably not realistic that you're gonna hit them anytime soon. So I like to have a mixture of goals of things that I can hit soon, not soon like tomorrow, but within a few months. And then I also like to have goals that I can hit within a year. And those are the goals that I write down every single day and night, right? A lot of, my longer term goals, I do those in the workshop that I learned from Jim Rohn. So for example, one of the goals that I write down day in and day out is how I want to help my mom and my aunt move into a new place. Obviously, I come from a very poor background. And so the place my mom is still living in back in Boston, of course, it's like a very, very poor neighborhood. It's in a small apartment. And one of my goals is for sure to help her move. And also I have family in the Dominican Republic. That's where I'm from. I also have an aunt that lives there. Again, lives in a poor environment, poor community. And I want to be able to help her as well. Now, I know for me, that's not a lifetime goal, because I know that I can help their situation. I would say within a few months time frame, once I have things settled in and I have cash flow that I can use to I obviously allocate to that. But I know that's something that's not gonna take me like 10 years to accomplish, right? I know for sure if I put my mind to it, I can definitely do that within a lot shorter time frame, right? I know that for a fact. In DR, it's a third world country, so obviously the economics is a lot different over there. So I can help my aunt over there with not even that much money, right? Maybe with like $1,000 or so, I can easily do that. And so my goal is to be able to do a lot more than just help with $1,000. I wanna be able to completely support them and have them live a lot better of a lifestyle. But that's just an example, right? That's a goal that I wanna achieve within the next year or so. It's huge for me because it really fuels my purpose, right? I have a joke specifically with Samir. Whenever he doesn't have his goals written down, whenever I know that he doesn't have his goals written down, I go over to him and mess around with him and say like, hey man, you're just walking around the day with no purpose. You have no goal set. You don't even know what you're working towards. And so me writing down my goals day in and day out consistently remind me of my purpose, right? What kind of things I'm working towards. And I find that whenever I don't write down my goals, I'm just going along with my day with no purpose, right? I feel like I don't really have a purpose with that day or have a purpose overall, because if you have no goals, you don't really know what you're working towards. You can do just a goal setting workshop, but having goals set in general, I like to personally always have an idea and know the kinds of things that I'm working for, because it keeps me motivated, right? When I'm going through my day and things are getting tough for me, and I think about the goals that I have set, it's a quick reminder, right? Like, get it in check, let's get things done, let's not slack off. And so it's super important, because if you don't have any goals, if you don't really have anything fueling you and you're not really working towards anything, then again, you're not really going to be as motivated. As for you guys, I know a lot of you guys watching, some of you guys may already be crushing your goals. And if you are, then great. If you haven't, I'd recommend for you guys 1000% start writing down your goals. Try every day if you think that'll help you stay a lot more accountable. If not, do the goal setting workshop. That goal setting workshop, I think everybody should do that, because it's huge and it opens you up to a lot. When I first did that goal setting workshop, I set some goals, and just 2 years after that, I realized that I had accomplished some of the goals that I had set to be accomplished in 5 years in 2 years. And it's honestly crazy to see the progress that I've made. And for you guys, it's gonna be the exact same thing. You guys are gonna love the progress once you see it. Really get that feeling of seeing the progress that you've made and really benefit from it if you don't have any goals set, because you don't have anything to reflect on. So you start writing down your goals if you haven't already. And as far as achieving them, when it comes to achieving them, I like to also, one thing that I like to do daily is set daily targets. The goals, obviously, they're good to have, but I also like to have daily targets, things that I want to do that day of. And daily targets, I feel like, are important as well, because there are things that you're doing to get closer to your goals, right? So obviously having your goals is good, but doing things the day of that can positively impact and influence how close you're gonna be to your goals is super important as well. Because if you're just setting goals, there's gonna be some goals that, again, they're gonna be long-term goals, right? And obviously there's gonna be things that you probably won't be able to do right away to that's gonna make it so you're getting closer to that goal. But having things in place, having daily targets in place every single day, make it so that you can really be effective every single day. Because again, it all comes down to going around with purpose, right? Of course, your purpose can fuel you, but if you have all that fuel and you're not selling targets of things you need to get done that day, then it's kind of like you just fueled up with nothing to really get done. And so you obviously want to be fueled up, but also have things in line that you want to get done. So I like to take my time. I like to pre-prepare. Usually the night before, I like to have an idea of like what my next day is going to consist of. And in the morning, I like to kind of map out my day and kind of map out the things that I have to get done. And usually I like to line things up where I'm doing the hardest things first. And then I'm doing the least exhaustive things, things that don't require as much thinking, as much power or energy towards the end. And so that's kind of the structure I have. And I know I went a little bit off topic with that, but if there's one takeaway that you guys should have from this video, it's for sure knowing the importance of goals and, you know, your purpose and how you can fuel your purpose, short-term, long-term, health goals. One of the goals that I write down every single day is like, not every day, one of my targets every single day is to eat clean meals and crush a workout. I feel like I don't even have to write those things down because those are kind of things that I try to do anyway. You know, that goes back to my physical goal that I have written down and that I wrote down in the goals that I wrote down when I did that workshop. Obviously, I want to be ripped. You know, I stay pretty consistent trying to work out and exercise and eat clean. And one of my daily targets every single day is, again, to always eat clean and crush a workout. And that's helping me work towards my long-term goal of just being in overall shape. If you guys like this video where I went over goals, you know, kind of how to achieve your goals, make sure you drop a like on this video. If you guys want to see a lot more in depth as far as like what kind of goals to set, the workshop, I want to know a lot more about goals in general, make sure you drop a comment below and just let me know some feedback, right? Comment goal setting in this video. Depending on how much feedback I get from it, maybe I'll make another goal video showing you guys how exactly I narrowed down what kind of goals I set, things like that. And of course, if you haven't already, make sure you join the VFAM, smash that subscribe button, and make sure you turn on post notifications. I'm actually gonna start doing weekly giveaways, cash giveaways, or book giveaways. I figured cash, obviously some of you guys that are doing like trying to start your own online business or trying to start up a business overall, that can really help you guys. But also I figured books can be super beneficial because I've learned a ton for books, right? I have this book, one book right here, Think and Grow Rich. This book right here, like, it was a game changer for me. And so let me know also, you know, drop a comment below. Let me know whether I should do cash or book giveaway as well. That's pretty much it for this video. I don't have too much to kind of go over. Of course, make sure you guys stay tuned. Make sure you subscribe, because to enter the giveaway and be a part of the giveaway, you have to be subscribed. You have to comment down below. Make sure you have post notifications on. I'll probably start it right after this. So I'll pick, depending on how many comments I get, either if I get more cash giveaways or more book giveaways, I'll pick one based on how many comments you guys leave me, and then I'll pick one winner, and then we'll go from there. So that's pretty much it. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.